Hi guys, and welcome back to another Talk to Race video, and today we're going to be playing Ride 4, and today we're going to be using the BMW HP2, and I must confess, this bike is really, really nice. I have never used it till this point, so this is going to be my first-hand experience, but a little bit of spoiler alert as mentioned already, it is pretty nice. I'm quite happy with this BMW, and I'll probably be using it a little bit more often. Now, it is surprising to me that I never used this bike before. I was just looking through and someone mentioned a few days ago in the Discord server that the BMW Boxer is a great bike, and of course the Boxer being that design of engine which was made in the early 1900s, I do believe. But I've got to say, I'm really impressed with this bike. It does feel very, very nice. I was actually pleasantly surprised with the brakes on this motorcycle. I thought they'd be a little bit weak, but they're a lot stronger than I thought, so this has been just getting used to it for now in Suzuka. A little bit of a time trial, and then we'll be doing a Grand Prix afterwards. But I will say, if you've not used this bike before, and if there is bikes as well on Ride 4 that you're yet to use, then hopefully this little series I'm going to be doing with bikes I've never used before could sort of inspire you and encourage you to try some bikes that you may have never used before. So we'll bring on the acceleration, we'll prepare ourselves for the chicane. I'm curious to see how it handles the particular chicane, and there you go. Absolutely beautiful. This bike can also nimbly move around a track such as Suzuka. I'm enjoying this one. I really am. We're going to see how it races just in a very short while as we complete the lap here in Suzuka, and then we'll go for a little bit of a race. And honestly, I think it's great. I really do. Another excellent suggestion from the Aces. And of course, if you do have any suggestions or requests in any way, shape or form, let me know in the comments section down below. And of course, if you are enjoying the content, hit the like button and subscribe as well. It helps out the channel quite a lot. But we now go to the left-hand side for that tighter apex for the 130R. A little bit eager on the acceleration, but we're absolutely fine. Go firm on the brakes, roughly the 100-meter marker. Slowly bringing in, and there you go. The brakes are even better than I anticipated. Very firm on the brakes. You can go, and the bike will just take it in its stride. Stability personified with the BMW Boxer. Very much impressed with that one, and that is a test passed. So we now move to Kanto on board the BMW HP2. It's going to be a very short sprint race this one, so we better make the moves pretty quick. So that's a decent start. Up on the left-hand side, we have a couple of riders, but I'm going to stay at the back here and wait to, hopefully, for no carnage to unfold, and then we'll start picking them off one by one. So on the left-hand side now, we're all on the BMW HP2, getting a little bit out of shape there, just can't really find my way around, and I'm not really in that much of a desperate rush right now, because we do have three laps, but the AI still aren't really that competitive. So we went around the outside of Serio Aki and now onto the right hand side to get the hopefully the little bit of a change of direction here. I don't think we're going to make it stick, but we could potentially try it around the outside. Not quite. I think too many riders are in the way at this current moment, but we'll now go on the right hand side, just gently braking, not trying to do anything too crazy like that absolute pillock who's just decided to dive up on the inside and almost kill us both. We're just trying to take it easy. We don't need to rush, we don't need to panic. When we bring on the acceleration here for this particular point, I'm guessing we're going to absolutely blast past them. So onto the rear now of the Brazilian, bring it around the outside, and then keep an eye on Itzo Nakano, because when we see that blue van, we'll be diving over the inside of him, no doubt. Can we get it up in the inside? Not quite. Going tighter to the apex there for City 1. City 2 is going to reveal itself now, so we can go on the right-hand side. He looks like he's gone a little bit wide, Nakano did, so we will have the acceleration to blast past the Japanese rider. Yuki Uchimura is also going to be next on our hit list for 7th position, and we'll try and outbreak him onto the left-hander, but still not quite. Oh, a bit of a bump from behind. I guess I'm being a little bit too tentative on the brakes, just taking it steady, not necessarily rushing it or just throwing it in everywhere, because it's just not necessary. We'll bring on the acceleration, we'll smash past the pair of these two. The Japanese rider and the Italian have been dispatched off. And now onto the right-hand side for turn one. We go in there 10 to 12 as we approach Dean Schmal, or Dan Schmal, my apologies. So can we have a little bit of a lunge, maybe on the change of direction coming up to the left-hand side? Position the bike in the right spot, and then we could lunge. Now I don't think I can get it done when he's taking that much spot. And someone has just gone down, didn't quite see who that was, but they just appeared on the outside of the track there. Coming up on the inside here, beautifully done. Desperately wanted a nice little lunge there, because I'm not a big fan of just overtaking everyone the acceleration. I do like a good move on the brakes, especially a change of direction as well. So fourth position is where we sit for the time being, but we'll go on the right hand side, and this particular part is where I do pick up the speed. I thought about maybe a lunge up on the inside there, but that would have been absolutely ridiculous. I would have been the so-called pillock that took out me just a moment ago, but never mind about that. We have Mariko Awizara, Simon Bellucci, and Alberto Duarte Pedroso as we now get up on the inside of the man in third position. So we now take third, and we'll try and get Simon Bellucci going around the outside of the city too. I don't think it's going to work there, but we will have that insane acceleration around the outside as we get very close to the wall there, if I do say so myself. But now bringing on the power, using a little bit of slipstream, and then getting firm on the brakes. We are absolutely slamming on the brakes there, and we've gone completely wide, and we may get a bit of penalty time there as I come onto the track a little bit too aggressively there. And now it's a 1 second lead to the Brazilian ahead of us. Are we going to struggle? I very much doubt it. It's just down to us now to chase him down. So we're in pursuit mode now. We left it a little bit too late. Probably would have already passed him if I was going for it full gung-ho. But I like this chance now of making it a little bit more exciting and entertaining towards the end of this Grand Prix here in Kanto. But now on the left-hand side for Jean 2. Super tight to the apex. A little bit of a flick of the control there just to avoid the helmet touching the wall on the left-hand side. But we're now going to the left-hand side once more now for Turn 5. Alberto Duarte Pedroso is still leading this Grand Prix, but I don't think it's going to be for much longer. 3.5 tenths of a second quicker we were in that first split. Now onto the left-hand side. I do fancy a lunge going into the change of direction here. Could we go around the outside to then stick it up on the inside? Can we get it done? He doesn't want any of it. He tried to go around the outside, but it didn't suffice. We managed to move on through. It's come to fruition for us, but Alberto Duarte Pedroso will remain in second place for now, as he's lost a little bit of more time just in this particular section already as we go. A little bit tight there for City 1. Probably should have taken a wider entry. And now into City 2, getting a much cleaner entry. And then fire this BMW up. Use the Boxer's strength, and that being the acceleration, and just blast it down this back street here. And the gap is already 1.3 seconds. Goodness me, we can brake nice and early here without too much stress or pressure, because we've just got the job well and truly done as we just touch the rumble strip there. A little bit of a scary moment, but that is job well and truly done. So guys, hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, let me know in the comment section down below. Hit the like button if you really enjoyed the content, and consider subscribing for a lot more DrAce content. Ciao for now.
Oh, hi! Didn't quite see you there. Good to see you're still here. If this video didn't quite set your appetite, then why not watch some more DrAce content by clicking the video shown on screen now. Furthermore, if you would like to follow me on social media, you can do so now with the links down in the description. Consider subscribing so you don't miss a single DrAce video.